bond pairs. Shortly, I am going to represent by BP. And how many lone pairs are present? Each nitrogen atom has a pair of electron which doesn't participate in bond. So, each nitrogen atom contributes one lone pair and there will be two lone pair in the molecule of nitrogen. Three bond pairs and two lone pairs are present in the molecule of nitrogen. What the terminology we have just learned, it's lone pair and bond pair. This will help us to study the classification of covalent compounds. Now we have to see the classification of covalent bonds. Classification of covalent bond. We can classify the covalent bond by using the different terminology, but first classification what we are going to see is based on the number of bond pairs. On the basis of number of shared bond pairs. On the basis of this, we can classify the covalent bond in three types. First is single covalent bond. Second one is double covalent bond. And third one is triple covalent bond. As the name is indicating, single covalent bond means if the two atoms are bonded with each other by a single bond or by one covalent bond, so this will be termed as single covalent bond. We have seen earlier that one covalent bond is formed by two electrons, by the sharing of two electrons. On the other hand, I can say that one covalent bond is formed by the sharing of one bond pair. So, between two atoms, if one bond pair is shared, this will result in a single covalent bond. On the other hand, if two atoms are combined with each other by two covalent bonds, so this will be the example of double covalent bond. This is found in the molecule of oxygen. Two covalent bonds are present, means four electrons are going to be shared. On the other hand, I can say that two bond pairs are shared between these two atoms. Triple covalent bond, we have seen in the molecule of nitrogen. If two atoms are combined with each other by three covalent bonds, so this can be termed as the triple covalent bond between two atoms. For three bonds, we required sharing of six electrons, or we can say by the sharing of three bond pairs. So, on the basis of shared bond pairs, if one bond pair is shared between two atoms, that will be single covalent bond. If two bond pairs are sharing, so it will be double, and if the three bond pairs are going to be shared between two atoms, it will be triple covalent bond. Second classification is on the basis of electronegativity. On the basis of difference in electronegativity. I am going to represent this electronegativity shortly by E dot N. On the basis of electronegativity, we can classify the covalent bond in two parts. First is polar covalent bond. And second one is non-polar covalent bond. How this classification is made? So we can understand easily this by the example of HCl. In the molecule of HCl, one hydrogen atom is going to combine with another chlorine atom, and since these two are non-metallic in nature, so there may be a covalent bond between these two atoms. This will be clear by the electronic configuration of these two atoms. Hydrogen has atomic number 1, it has one valence electron. And chlorine has atomic number 17 and the electronic configuration will be 2, 8 and 7. we can see from the electronic configuration, both the atoms need one more electron to get the stability. And if I am to write the Lewis symbol for these atoms, the symbol of hydrogen, one valence electron by using one dot. Chlorine, 7 valence electron. So I am going to represent this by making 7 crosses. Both the electrons need one more electron. So they will contribute one electron for the sharing. And by the sharing of one electron from each atom, there will be 2 electrons between these two atoms. That will result in the formation of single covalent bond. Hydrogen, single covalent bond with another chlorine atom. Now if we say about these electrons which are going to be shared, so there is equal contribution by each atom. Both the atoms contributed one electron for the sharing. So these electrons should be at the middle position between these two atoms. But further, when the bond is formed, so these two atoms start attracting these two electrons towards themselves. Chlorine wants these electrons towards itself and hydrogen start attracting these electrons towards itself. This attracting power of any atom towards the bond pair of electron is termed as electronegativity. Since the value of electronegativity for chlorine is greater than the electronegativity of hydrogen, so there will be a high force of attraction on these electrons towards the chlorine atom and the net force will be towards chlorine atom. So the final condition for this bond is hydrogen, single covalent bond, chlorine, and now these two electrons which were initially at the mid of these two atoms, now they will slightly shift towards chlorine atom. And the position will be like this. Due to this shifting, now chlorine will acquire a charge. And this charge will be partially negative charge, which can be represented as delta minus. And hydrogen will acquire a partially positive charge, which is represented as delta positive. Earlier we have seen in the definition that covalent bond is formed by the mutual sharing of electrons. And if both the atoms contribute equally, so in the covalent bond we should not see any kind of charge. But now due to the difference in electronegativity of bonded atoms, if the charge is developed, so this kind of bond is termed as polar covalent bond. And this was the basis of our classification. First, what the covalent bond, polar covalent bond. Polar covalent bond means those bonds in which the partially charge are developed on the bonded atoms is termed as polar covalent bond. For example, HCl, HF, HI are the example of this kind of covalent bond. Both the atoms have the difference in their electronegativity, so they will acquire positive or negative charge on their atoms. And the second kind of covalent bond, which follows the ideal condition of bonding, is non-polar covalent bond. Non-polar covalent bond. This kind of bond is formed between two atoms which have the same electronegativity. For example, in the molecule of hydrogen, in the molecule of chlorine, fluorine or bromine, this kind of bond is formed because as we can see, both the atoms are equal. For example, if we say bromine molecule, bromine single covalent bond, another bromine atom. This is formed by the sharing of one electron pair between these two bromine atoms. Now, if we talk about the electronegativity of bromine, so since the both atoms are same, they will have the same force of attraction on these valence electrons, and we can see the both force are in the opposite direction, so the net force will be zero, and due to this, they will not have any kind of charge on these two atoms. So this is the example of non-polar covalent bond.